I mean, we sacrificed everything. It was a massive hit. We followed up with Buttons, another massive global hit. So we had then sort of given up our lives for the Pussycat Dolls to travel, to do all the promo, to do the tours. We toured with the Black Eyed Peas for a year and a half. Then we headlined our own tour after off a first album, which doesn't happen very often, having Gaga. No, it was Rihanna and Neo opened for us on our first big tour. The next one, it was Gaga opening for us. So, you know, as much as you're dealing with these inner battles, you're also living the dream. Mm. And you know that there is a gazillion girls behind you that will take that spot and deal with everything you're dealing with in a moment, in a blink of an eye. Mm. So at the same time, that dog eat dog world is just fueling you to like, no, I gotta make this happen. But like you said, that you can't hold on to that forever. Yeah, so I broke. I got IBS. And I just knew that my stomach was not okay. I didn't know what it was called at that point. But I had a moment where I'd run off stage, didn't feel okay. I was in the toilet and it wasn't coming out. I just didn't know what was going on. And a whole ambulance came and they broke down the door. And I had three people looking me over. They sent everybody out and laid me down on the ground and were checking through my body and asking me questions about my amount of stress and anxiety I had and what I was dealing with and the circumstances. So they sent me off tour back to the States to go to the hospital and get a colonoscopy and get loads of different checks. And the girls continued the tour without me. And I had to go figure it out. And when I woke up from the colonoscopy and they said, yeah, we didn't really find a whole lot, so we think you probably have IBS and you're going to have to get your stress and anxiety under control. That was a huge turning point. And to be sitting there trying to recover, seeing, like, I think it was Arena in Manchester singing me happy birthday at a show that I couldn't show up to because my body just couldn't deal with it anymore. But it made me feel very sad and very vulnerable and really replaceable. So I was like, yeah, they're right. They can continue without you, you know? There was an example. So then I started having to look at life a little bit differently. I started figuring out, like, What is the purpose of all of this? Why am I sustaining this amount of stress and anxiety? And, you know, what would life look like without it? What would I be doing?
One quick note, sad one. Kimberly is not with us tonight, you guys. She's very ill. And it's her birthday today. So can we please give a big round of applause because we miss her so much.
We miss her so much.
Thank you.